would be good.
Each of those little pieces and you make slivers. And you just go around it. Squeeze each one just like this.
Explain niyo po, Pastor. Ano pong ginagawa niyo?
Ha? Ano pong niluluto nyo?
Biscuits. Hindi mo na magugasa ng kamay kasi may lasa din yun.
Yeah.
After mag-CR, di ba kasi yung alat sa ihi? Sa...
Hindi po kami kakain niya. Hindi yung okay na sana kung walang explanation.
Si Ma'am po nag-gloves pag nagbe-bake eh.
Kailangan niya pa ng gloves.
Wala na, late na. Siyempre nagugustan kamay, ano kayo?
Ano pong recipe niyan? Biscuits niyo? Ingredients po?
Flaky biscuits. Flour.
Di ba secret po? Hindi sasabihin.
May secret din pati kama, hindi nyo makuha yan. Flour, baking soda, sugar, salt, butter.
Ay, Miss Bren! Paano to ilalive?
Hindi, alam nila na. Saka wala naman siguro ang Facebook sa Pasko.
Ay, oo nga. Ilalive ko sana. Opo, babalik daw po siya saglit.
There's lots of ways. And I'm not really making this video for anyone who already has biscuits mastered. They make great biscuits, and I know there's different ways to do it. But what I want to do is try to help those that have never really got the hang of it. So I really want to show you how to do it, just step by step, very simple, very easy. I also found out that in other parts of the world they call these scones. So that's pretty interesting. So not only can I make biscuits, but I can make scones. And so can you once you learn how to do this. So you just work it together like this and find each of those little pieces and you squeeze them and make slivers. Get them all mixed up. And then you want to make a well in the center to pour your milk into. And of course, that's next. I'm using slightly less than 1/2 cup of regular whole milk. Just like that. And now you need something to stir with. And gentle. especially if you like biscuits. I suppose this is the most critical part, learning how to not overwork the dough. That's really the secret to good, fluffy, flaky biscuits. Be very gentle. So I'm just stirring it as little as possible, just trying to get all the moisture to pick up the dry flour. See, I'm not really even stirring it, I'm just kind of moving it around and turning it over. And once it reaches this stage, it's time to use your hands. Of course, my hands are very clean. And you begin to reach down underneath and try to scoop up the dry flour and lift it to the top. Gently incorporate it all into the dough ball. Up and kind of pour it on top like that. But the main thing is not to overwork the dough. Just to be very, very careful with it, very gentle with it. I know I'm using that word a lot, but it's because it's so important. Next, we're going to go ahead and get a piece of wax paper. You don't have to have wax paper. I just like doing it. It makes it easier to clean up after you're done. It also is a pan.